Actually, the creation of the World Trade Organization marked the end of the success of the world trading system. The world trading system triumphed through 8 rounds of multilateral negotiations successfully completed among all the major nations of the world, starting in 1948 and ending with the Uruguay round. Then the World Trade Organization was created, and it's actually been a failure ever since. So the right way of thinking about the trading system is that it's an agreement among countries. The organization, unlike the IMF, is much less important. As a matter of fact, world trade is clearly not a growth factor anymore. It's growing more slowly than the world economy. There is rising protection. It's very, very clear that trade is becoming a brake on growth rather than a source of dynamism. But alas, that also means growth overall is lower than it would otherwise be. The world economy is relatively weak. It's not growing as it did before the crisis. So the loss of the dynamism is a tragedy. It is perfectly possible to have trade while we also have sustainable development. But to do that, we need to internalize the costs of energy, of transport, within all economic transactions. At that point, some trade will certainly disappear, the useless parts of trade, but some will continue to be quite beneficial. It's actually cheaper from an environmental point of view, for example, to import beef from Brazil or Argentina than grow it in very bad climatic conditions.